Hi, my name is Astrid Juncker from IPK Gottesleben. I'm heading here the Acclimation Dynamics and Phenotyping group, and for today I would like to advertise my presentation on the automated phenotyping of crop acclimation capacity towards integration mechanisms and resilience. And as you're probably all aware of, plants do not exist in static environments. However, they have to continuously adapt and acclimate to changes in their environment, which, as you can see from this weather diagram, occur on a wide range of different scales. In that context, acclimation is defined as the physiological, biochemical, or morphological modification to a phenotype that results from environmental challenges. Acclimation capacity critically influences plant performance and resilience to climate change. Therefore, optimization of acclimation potential may offer an important route towards improving plant productivity. Understanding the phenotypic changes as well as the underlying processes involved in acclimation will be a very important step. An automated and non-invasive plant phenotyping and controlled environment is key. At IPK, we have set up several phenotyping systems, for example, a conveyor-based plant-to-sensor phenotyping system for large plants. Here, plants are moved to imaging chambers and special carriers and will be imaged daily in different wavelength ranges. Using automated image analysis pipelines, we are able to extract hundreds of architectural, color, and even physiological traits, such as photosynthesis, from these images. Here you can see one example for the image-derived digital biovolume, which is a proxy for biomass over time of development of a maize plant. All these systems that we have set up at IPK are located in glasshouses in controlled conditions where very homogeneous and optimal conditions occur. These, however, are very divergent from natural conditions in the field, where we have a strong differences in terms of absolute values for illumination, temperature, and so on. So it's not surprising that the correlations between lab and field are very low, at about only 0.26. So in order to overcome this gap in the lab-to-field translation, Thomas Altmann and his crew at IPK has set up a unique and novel plant growth and phenotyping infrastructure, the Plant Cultivation Hall. In this plant growth facility, it's possible to simulate field-like conditions, including controlled fluctuations, to elicit trait expression resembling that of typical field situations. The two complementary phenotyping systems therein allow, on the one hand, a detailed analysis of root systems architecture, and on the other hand, plants can be grown, as in the field, as plots in large volume growth containers, which are filled with a soil, with a field-like soil horizon, and which have the possibility to be climatized. With this, I would like to stop for now. I thank you for your attention. I hope you got interested and want to hear more. In my presentation, I introduce some applications and examples of how we use our phenomics infrastructure for the assessment of acclimation capacity. Looking forward to talk to you on November 10. Bye-bye.